Gary Kahn, so I know about this, but tell us about Gary Kahn.
Gary Kahn is an annual convention I hold in honor of my father, and we celebrate his life and works with my family members, and it's in Lake Geneva, Wisconsin, which is where Dungeons & Dragons was created in our hometown. And it's in March because he passed away in March, and so this is our way to gather and make happy memories out of this normally sad occasion. And it started off as it came out of his funeral. After his funeral, so many people had expressed how important he was. I thought that we should have a gathering outside of just the funeral service. And so we got together at the American Legion Hall, which was the site of Gen Cons, which is a big gaming convention a long, long time ago. And we had food and refreshments, and we played games and ran the Dungeons & Dragons cartoon on the wall and had a podium for people to come up and share stories about my dad. And it was so fun. People enjoyed it so much, they said, hey, Luke, you should do this again next year. And Jolly Blackburn, who's a creator of Knights of the Dinner Table, a little comic book, said you can call it Gary Kahn, because he has a convention there called Gary Kahn for his character Gary Jackson, which is which is a combination of Steve Jackson and my dad, who are two very famous old game designers.
Yeah.
And so I did, and I just started off as a game day, and I wasn't charging any money. And then like over 150 people came, and then 240, and then now we're up to over 2,000 people that come to the Lake Geneva, a town of 5,000 people in the
middle. That's incredible.
Of Wisconsin, and they come from all over the world to come and play games with the guys I consider my uncles, as well as the new game designers. You know, we have Mike Merles, the franchise creative director of Dungeons & Dragons, comes. Peter Atkinson, the guy who owns Gen Con and was, the head of Wizards of the Coast for many years.
That's incredible.
It's fans, yeah.
Yeah.
And as well as just, Tim Kask, Frank Mentzer, Jim Ward, lots and lots of artists. Jeff Easley, great artist. Larry Elmore, Errol Otis, all these guys.
Starting a movement.
Yes, yeah. And so it's
continuing a movement, actually.
Yes. Yeah. And you know what? And I think it's wonderful because my dad loved gaming. Mm-hmm. He didn't love a specific facet of gaming. He didn't say you can only enjoy these games. So it's about gaming with a capital G. So if you want to come and you want to play whatever, even if you want to play Magic the Gathering card game, that's okay. You're playing a game and having fun. You can play. We do have some really wonderful games there. Get a little bit more geeky here for a second.
Go for it.
The Legends of Wargaming series is, it basically pairs old scenarios of like games that were played maybe at Gen Con 2 or Siege of Bodenburg, some of these old games, or Tractics, which is an armor miniatures battle system that my dad did with Mike Reese. Well, Mike Reese still comes and he will run Tractics for you in a scenario that was run in Gen Con 3 or something like that. A game that is a precursor to Dungeons & Dragons, the first idea, like where the kernels of role-playing came from, is a game called Bronstein by David Wesley. He comes to Gary Kahn. He's still alive. He comes to Gary Kahn.
Oh, wow.
Yeah, you can play Dungeon, the Dungeon board game, which also is a contemporary of Dungeons & Dragons. It came out, it was designed before Dungeons & Dragons was published because they were concurrent. Dave McGarry played with Dave Arneson, who was one of the developers of Dungeons & Dragons, along with my dad. And so he made a game that you could self-play. He comes and runs on his original board there. So you can play all these old scenarios with guys who were there and wrote the rules and still do it. So it's a look back, or you can play with Mike Merles, the 5e right now, or Jason Bullman from Pathfinder, or all these guys come because they all love gaming, they respect what my father did, and so they want to come and have fun. And that's what we do. So it's really wonderful. Thing, and if you get a chance to come to Lake Geneva in March, you should do it.
I would love to. Where do we even fly in for that? It's such a small town.
It is. It's about an hour and a half from Chicago O'Hare, or about an hour from Milwaukee. So you fly into one of those two spots, and then you drive to Lake Geneva and play. But yeah, despite the challenges of coming to small town Wisconsin in March, we get people who do it who come from Norway, China, Australia, Italy, England, from all over the place, Canada, both coasts. I've met more people from Los Angeles there than I have here. Yeah.
In Los Angeles.
Than I have in Los Angeles. Yeah, they're like, oh yeah, I live out in LA. I'm like, oh no way. Yeah. So I'm really and we meet in Wisconsin, so it's kind of funny. So
that's such a blessing. Yeah.
It is. It is. So it's a wonderful legacy that I have the pleasure and honor to help carry out. And I'm primarily a soldier. That's my job. So I just fit this in as I can, but it's I get so much help because people are so generous in the gaming community. I've mentioned a lot of people's names. You know, your Peter Eggson, Michael Merles, Jason Bowman. All these guys are wonderful, and Steve Chenault, who's from Trollord Games. I mean, these guys all are so willing to help me with things. They go out of their way to help me make GaryCon happen and make it great. So I'm just a recipient of so much generosity and love and warmth in the community that it's a lot of work, but it's worthwhile to see all this happiness come to fruition.
It's incredible. I would love to see that. It almost sounds like a movie, what you're describing. I feel like I'm watching a movie in my head.
And it's pretty cool, and I do want to do a documentary on GaryCon, and it's just, again, you know, it's another thing, another task to add on there, but I should get to do that. Probably the closest you can get right now to seeing in a documentary format or film format is it's being kickstarted right now, so I'll give a shameless plug to my friend Pat Kilbane. He's doing a documentary called The Dreams in Gary's Basement, and he went to GaryCon and shot a lot of the video there, but a lot of the people that I'm talking about as attending are there also discussing about the origins of Dungeons & Dragons and how it came to fruition. So there's just a lot of interest in this subject matter right now. You have books like Empire of Imagination, which is a biography of my dad by a guy named Michael Whitwer. And he worked with John Peterson, who's another author, did Playing at the World, which is a collegiate level study of gaming. Sam Whitwer and Kyle Newman, who are a voice actor and a director, and they did the Art and Arcana, which is a beautiful, just came out a couple days ago, beautiful history of the visual history of the Dungeons & Dragons art. So that's cool, that's coming out, or that's out now. Eye of the Beholder, it's a documentary on the art of D&D, and that should be coming out shortly by a friend of mine, Brian Stillman. And that's just, I've seen an advanced copy of it. It's amazing. So, so it's just, there's a lot of interest. So it's a good time to be a geek right now.
Oh, yeah. Yeah. Oh, yeah. Of all ages, too. Yes. That's exciting. Well, yeah. Thank you so much for talking to us. And did we get all the information to where to find you, where to find all this?
Sure. You can find me, Luke Gygax. You can find all my social medias that way. And, of course, GaryCon.com is where you can find out about GaryCon.